That I would try to. I would do it. Try me.
That's funny.
But I would go to sleep, and when I wake up, when I wake up,
if you wake up, no, you'll
probably won't want to get stoned for a week.
I don't believe that.
I just did $250,000 worth of oil, bro.
It's like getting drunk. It's like getting drunk.
That's funny.
Well, no, I ate a shit ton of MGs. So it was like milligrams. I had like 300 milligrams one night. I really didn't get stoned the entire next day. I didn't want to. Everybody was dabbing. I'm like, I'm really good, guys. I really just don't want to do anything right now.
I think there was one day in my whole life where I actually said, I can't today. Just one. And that was rare.
Oh, man.
A lot of days happen that are good. It builds up.
That's funny. I love it. I love talking about it. Yeah. It needs to be talked about, really. It
absolutely
does.
It's been too taboo.
I don't want to be threatened for trafficking where I have my $250,000 worth of oil and I have to drink it all before the cop gets to the car or window. I mean, that would be bad.
It's
fun. That's not what we want here.
Makes me think of Trailer Park Boys.
It's a private fucking jet. A private jet. What do you mean weed's illegal here? Well, I brought it over in a private jet. Well, you can't bring weed from America to Ireland, dude. It's
a private.
He's like, you got any weed? And he's like, yeah, what do you need? I got this one.
He's like, no, we're just kidding. Wait, you really do? Are you serious? He's like, are you fucking kidding me right now?
The new one's funny where they out of the park.
They go to the European trip?
Well, they come to the United States and they got tasks to do. It's pretty funny.
Oh, shit.
Ricky winds up taking acid. It's
oh, my God.
Shit.
I got to watch the new ones. Then.
He thinks Martians, a little green
Martians. I saw
Martians
the one that launched in the UK. I saw the one that launched in the UK, like the 6 episodes they did.
Yeah, like, this one's
great.
Like a 6 or 7
right
episode.
When they released that, I was already like 6 months in planning with the crew to come out and do like a small like documentary tour with me to follow me around and me and Chris. But it was like $2,000 a day to afford them on the road.
Wow.
No,
we didn't have that.
$2,000 a day.
It was, no, sorry, $2,000 a month. I'm sorry, Chris. Yeah. Thank you, Chris. That's thank right. you. It was $2,000 a month to afford them on the road, and I couldn't afford their you know.
Yes, the day a month, it's still too much money.
Yeah, I mean, it's,
right? Well, can I go?
$500 a week. $500 a week to feed and drive a van around without having to worry about the pay from shows. That's not including pay from shows. Pay from shows would carry, you know, cover other excess expenses. But just to have an extra $2,000 a month would have covered their expenses just to make sure that they're always behind us. But that's... That went out the window. They tried in the van. The van broke down. They had to turn around in Indianapolis, and then they had to go back.
But imagine 6 months of footage traveling with the band on the road like this, of it documented, being submitted.
It being edited every night. It gets edited every night while the driver's driving, following us behind us to the next show. So it's
crazy.
Two people in a van, one of them
riding.
I mean, it's really cool. I mean, I really want to do it, but nobody wanted to fund it, and there's other things, and everybody's got different ideas and different options, and there's other bands to follow, and why not, you know, but... Shit, do it, man. Just fucking entertain us. Come on. We're just giving you ideas. Just fucking do it, damn it. We're bored.
Well, I hear you.
I'll do it for you if you don't want to do it.
That's funny shit. I love it.
We can actually probably go pro at this point and then submit it and send it somewhere cloud and actually work and process it.
Yeah, there's a cloud system to
do it.
But they want. I've got friends in North Carolina that call me every 2 or 3 to 6 months now asking me if I'm interested in their Citrix business for transfer data to their file sharing thing. And I'm like, well, my friend in Tennessee don't quite have a computer. He's been using his cell phone to do stuff, so I can't really send him anything to edit right now. He's kind of out of operation, so I'm just gonna hold off on the service. Plus, I don't have $60 a month to pay for it. So
I hear you.
Go away. Stop calling me on the phone.
Yeah, everybody's always got something they want you to get involved in.
You know. But iTunes is free, so you can go to iTunes.com/AR /submissions. And if your band has over 20,000 likes on your page, you can go to iTunes.com/AR.
You have to have 20,000 likes?
To get an AR representative.
Gotcha.
And you can put my name down there as AR for you, because that's kind of nice.
Has that always been the requirement?
The AR representative submission. If you have over 20,000, you get 20 cents per cone. If you have under 10,000, you get 10 cents a cone.
Yeah. Gotcha.
If we get bigger acts, that number will go up.
And since I'm like the first one on the grandfathered in of the market, and I'm going to I guess I have bragging rights, so I get to collect 25 cents on my cone. I walk into a store and I get a, since I work for the industry, I get my employee discount, and I pay $8 for my 1 gram of weed, and I pay myself 25 cents. So in homage and tribute to my friend, 8 1/4.
That's fine.
That's perfect. Funny. I got him a cone too, man. I'm like, you have to get a cone, bro, and come to Washington and buy your own. He's in Tennessee. He's like, I can't even smoke my own product.
That's funny.
So I love it. He wrote a song for HiTunes and everything, and it was really cool. Cocaine wrote a song for HiTunes also, and you should check that out too. It's going to be released in January, probably by the 15th. They're releasing a video for it. So stay tuned with HiTunes.
Do you know who the highest selling artist is on HiTunes?
Swisher Sleep and me were
nice
in two different categories of rankings. So I sold the most out of the stores, and he sold the most in stores. Or wow. I've sold the most in stores. No, I don't know what the number is. There was some kind of like controversial number, but he and I were like the first ones in there, and we were all in all the stores. But I think I had a job, and I had Chris. Chris and I ended up buying like a lot of our own shit, and we would go to the shows. And since the sharing laws got raised in Washington, we'd be like, "Hey, we've got our own cones. We'll share it with you outside, because why not? You know, we don't want to party alone."
Right.
So, and we also get a gram for $8. Fuck, dude.
You get the discount.
I literally got the best.
That also was that we didn't get as much sales because more discounts were applied on our sales, and we were in the market longer than Swisher was.
Right. Well, I want to say one thing. I got the best birthday present that one of my friends could have ever possibly given me. I got my own weed on the market on my birthday in Seattle, Washington. With my name on it. Like, it's just, I mean, yeah, my name and logo, cool. With my music available, you can scan a QR code, it goes to Tear Apart, and you can download the song for free or watch the music video. It's just, it was a really awesome gift and a cool gesture and a great thing to be a part of. I can't wait to go back in February and continue working with them. We have a lot of big things coming. I can't really release a lot of information at all because I'm privy to conversations that are straight up NDA signed things that I haven't signed, but I'm just not talking about too much.
I hear you, but when you do, when you are ready to talk about it, this is the place.
So. Oh yeah, I'm gonna call you over there. Hopefully, you're gonna have to call me. You're just gonna be like, Yoshi, answer your damn phone, bro. God damn it, we tried to call him and he didn't answer. We're gonna call Chris. Call Chris. Hey Chris, we'll talk to him for a minute. Someone will be like, Yoshi, Chris is on the radio show. He's ruining the show, man. You need to get on there. Oh, shit. Chris is on the air. Oh, I forgot a radio show. Shit, they got Chris. Well, he at least he answers his phone.
There was someone that contacted Chris me that wanted to come on the air with you and talk about HiTunes. I can't remember the guy's name.
But I believe it was Scott McKinley.
It might
or was it Jason England?
It was Jason England.
Can we call him right now?
I don't know. Can we?
Can you call people?
I'll give you his number.
That'd be awesome.
He's a really, really great guy to talk to. He's got a lot of nice stuff to say. He's a very positive gentleman.
You want me to patch your cell phone in here, or
you can if you want to do it. Do you want a cell phone number or do you want it on Facebook? I got his number. I'm not going to tell you over the air, but
ready to go video.
I can call him on Facebook.
Yeah, he'll do Facebook chat with you. He'll do video chat with you even. Shit,
that'd be awesome.
Let me see here if I can get him on there on one of them calls. Let me play a song real quick. We'll be right back. Come on, play.
Your silence now crashing all around.
chasing blood around my frame. A living shrine just for you, if you'll be mine. A golden band upon your hand. Leave this endless winter behind, my sweet Josephine. Won't you come?
All right, we're back with Yoshi Gish, Chris, Ryan, and now Jason on the line. So what's going on?
How's it going out there, guys?
Good, good. So we brought you on because we're in the middle of this conversation with music and the marijuana industry. So Yoshi wanted to give you a call, so we got you on the line.
Hey, Jason, how do you feel about the M word?
Which word?
The M word. Marijuana.
Oh, that was a hot button out here. I wasn't expecting that. It's cannabis. It's cannabis. We don't take kindly to any degradation of character or defamation of any plant. It's really bad what happened to the cannabis marijuana thing back in the past.
Can you
Is that where you're...
Yeah, yeah. Tell me what you know about the Cannabis Saves Lives tour.
Well, I know it has Tim A and Kat Bonsack and Yoshi Gish. I'm not sure who else is going to be on it.
We might get Afro Man on a couple shows in some cities that are allowing him to play. But some people are still digging him, and some people are still kind of on the fence with his history. But we're still totally supportive of him and his music career and what he's doing. You know, people make mistakes, and
he's got high.
We've done Afro Man shows.
I think he's great.
Oh yeah, man. Yeah, Virginia Rose Band did a show with him too.
Nice.
Around Bonfire. That's what was cool.
Yeah, he's played right down here when it was. I forgot the name of the club it was, but it was down the block. He used to play there all the time.
That's great. So Jason, we're gonna do this Cannabis Saves Lives tour. We're gonna go through a couple states, and when we get back to Washington, we're gonna try to do maybe like a cannabis cruise, or maybe before or after we do the tour. But we're gonna do cannabis cruises, aren't we?
Yeah, we're going to be on boats with rock stars and different philanthropists, making sure that money's going into causes and other things.
Right. Causes like we have autism, cancer awareness, veterans, the Rescue 22, the 22 Too Many.
Yeah, that's the Veterans Anti-Suicide Group that we give money to.
Right. Yeah, tell us.
What's his role in the whole... The whole game. What's your role as far as the music, the high tunes, all of that, so people know who you are?
Well, the owner of High Tunes is Scott McKinley, and I work with Scott McKinley on a project called Causes. I'm the lead on that one, and the focus of what I do is humanity.